Let's talk about intestinal permeability or leaky gut. This is a situation where there are holes in your intestine and your food particles are getting into these holes, into the lymphatic system, and then your immune system is going to react to it. You're going to have all sorts of allergies, you're going to have inflammation, then you're going to get scar tissue. And now I've done other videos on this and I've talked more about certain foods that destroy your gut lining and that cause a leaky gut, like gluten, for example, taking antibiotics, consuming foods that are inflammatory. But in this video, I want to talk about another control mechanism that is superior to that, and it is the vagus nerve. The vagus nerve comes from the brainstem and it goes throughout the entire thorax into your abdomen, it goes down into your pelvis, and it's a very long nerve, and you actually have two of them, okay? And 80% of that nerve goes down and only 20% goes up. And so we have this huge communication network between our brain and our gut. And so the vagus nerve helps to maintain this intestinal barrier to prevent pathogens and other things from crossing over into your body. Now, they've done experiments on vagal nerve stimulation to show how that can protect the gut barrier. Now, from my experience, I don't recommend stimulating your vagus nerve. There's other ways to go about this, but they did find that when you stimulate the vagus nerve, it actually protects this barrier, this gut barrier. Also, low vagal activity, so when there's low function in your vagus nerve, you have an increase in permeability and inflammation. And so the vagus nerve is all a part of something called the autonomic nervous system. The vagus nerve is part of the division called the parasympathetic. And the parasympathetic is all about rest and digest. And so this division of the autonomic nervous system also helps you secrete hydrochloric acid. It helps you release enzymes from your pancreas. It helps you release bile from your gallbladder. It's involved in peristalsis. That's the pumping action of your colon. It helps you prevent inflammation and also controls the valves of the stomach, above the stomach and below the stomach, and helping to prevent a condition called GERD. And so the vagus nerve has this protective function in the intestinal epithelial barrier. Now, that's all very interesting, but the question is, what if we have a problem with the vagus nerve? What is the best thing to do? Well, there just happens to be a very key nutrient that supports the vagus nerve, and that is thiamine. And the question, where does it come from? It comes from grains. But here's the problem. When you consume grains have gluten, and that will destroy the gut. So you don't want to get your B1 from grains. In fact, consuming grains creates a deficiency of B1. You want to get your B1 from nutritional yeast. You can also get it from sunflower seeds. If you have gut issues, I think it's very, very important to not neglect vitamin B1 in the control of intestinal permeability. Hey, before you go, if you're benefiting from any of my content, I would love to hear about your success story. Please share it in the link down below.